coming on the air right now because President Obama has just met with President-elect Donald Trump in the Oval Office. We saw Donald Trump fly down from New York earlier today. We have as promising to try to bring the country together. We heard that, of course, in his acceptance speech on Wednesday morning. President Obama, when he spoke yesterday, says we all have to be rooting for Donald Trump's success. But, of course, in the wake of that, protests overnight in several American cities, thousands of protesters out in the streets, hundreds were arrested, protesting Donald Trump, including right here at the Trump Tower in Manhattan. The president and President-elect Trump met for about an hour in the Oval Office. Poole was brought in at the end. And Melania Trump, in her first visit to the White House, expected to have tea with the First Lady, also accompanied by their son-in-law, by Donald Trump's son-in-law, Jared Kushner, who's played a key role in this campaign, a key advisor to the president. Let's listen into what we heard.
Okay. Well, I just had the opportunity to have an excellent conversation with President-elect Trump. It was wide-ranging. We talked about some of the organizational issues in setting up a White House. We talked about foreign policy. We talked about domestic policy. And as I said last night, my number one priority in the coming 2 months is to try to facilitate a transition that ensures our president-elect is successful. And I have been very encouraged by the, I think, interest in President-elect Trump's wanting to work with my team around many of the issues that this great country faces. And I believe that it is important for all of us, regardless of party and regardless of political preferences, to now come together, work together, to deal with the many challenges that we face. And in the meantime, Michelle has had a chance to greet the incoming First Lady, and we had an excellent conversation with her as well, and we want to make sure that they feel welcome as they prepare to make this transition. And most of all, I want to emphasize to you, Ms. President-elect, that we now are going to want to do everything we can to help you succeed, because if you succeed, then the country succeeds. Please. Sir.
Well, thank you very much, President Obama. This was a meeting that was going to last for maybe 10 or 15 minutes, and we were just going to get to know each other. We had never met each other. I have great respect. The meeting lasted for almost an hour and a half, and it could have, as far as I'm concerned, it could have gone on for a lot longer. We really, we discussed a lot of different situations, some wonderful and some difficulties. I very much look forward to dealing with the president in the future, including counsel. He explained some of the difficulties, some of the high-flying assets, and some of the really great things that have been achieved. So, Mr. President, it was a great honor being with you, and I look forward to being with you many, many more times in the future. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, everybody. We are not going to be taking any questions. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Here's a good rule. Don't answer any questions when they just start yelling.
It's always the last one.
Come on, guys. Yeah, come on, guys. Let's go.
Very, very good man.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate you. Thank you, guys.
President Obama making it clear right there, wasn't going to take any questions after that meeting with Donald Trump, his first meeting ever with Donald Trump, apparently a cordial meeting, as you heard the president say right there, an excellent wide-ranging conversation. Donald Trump also saying it was a good conversation, said he would seek the president's counsel in the future. And Jonathan Carl, I want to bring you in. You've covered both men for a long time, a lot of animosity. Even before this campaign, of course, Donald Trump questioned whether President Obama was even born in the United States. But that first meeting, apparently rather successful.
Yes, and there was a question that was answered, George. At the end there, I asked Donald Trump if he was really going to seek the president's counsel, and that's when he responded at the very end saying, he is a very good man. Those were words that I hadn't expected to hear from Donald Trump covering him all over these years. He talked about how he had respect for him, and he hoped to see him many, many more times in the future. Even made a reference, George, you heard there, to some of the excellent things that have been accomplished. So this was apparently a quite cordial meeting. As Trump mentioned, it lasted for an hour and a half. And I can tell you that while I was waiting to go inside the Oval Office, they had the pool waiting right next to the colonnade. I noticed that Jared Kushner, Donald Trump's son-in-law and close advisor, Ivanka Trump's husband, was walking around the South Lawn with Dennis McDonough, President Obama's chief of staff. They made that walk several times. That's a walk that the president often takes with his chief of staff when they discuss weighty matters. They even made a that was even where they talked about the bombing campaign that was to happen against Syria. Of course, didn't happen largely because of what the two men discussed on that walk. So it was very interesting to see not only the meeting between the incoming president and the outgoing president, but also the outgoing chief of staff and one of the incoming president's most important advisors.
And John, interesting that he's going to seek President Obama's counsel, given the fact that so many of his promises on the campaign trail are to undo many of President Obama's accomplishments in his first 100 days in office.
Well, and also given the unbridled animosity that we have seen between the two men. As you mentioned, Donald Trump questioned whether or not the president was even a citizen of the United States and therefore eligible to be president of the United States. And President Obama made no bones about the fact that he believed that Donald Trump was temperamentally unfit to be commander-in-chief. Now we see the two of them quite cordial words from each man. The president saying he is bound and determined to try to help Donald Trump be a successful president, a successful transition, because he thinks that will be that will mean success for the country as a whole. And this extraordinary statement from Donald Trump that he will be seeking counsel from a man he once said was not a legitimate president.
Cokie Roberts, cordial words, one of the rituals of democracy.
Yes, but you know, I think that Donald Trump has learned since the election that words really do matter. I mean, we had a dramatic instance of that where after the results were becoming clear, we saw the stock market futures drop by almost 1,000 points, 850 points or so. And then Donald Trump made that very conciliatory acceptance speech and stocks started to go up. And then Hillary Clinton and the president made their very conciliatory speeches yesterday, and the market soared. And that is something that it's very hard for presidents to learn, is that their words really do affect peace and war. They affect markets, and Donald Trump is learning that very quickly and is responding to it in a way that I think can make people feel a lot more comfortable.
And for the most part, avoided questions, with the exception of Jonathan Carl at that press conference. Cokie Roberts, John Carl, thanks very much. There you have it, the first meeting between President Obama, President-elect Donald Trump. Mr. Trump now heads up to Capitol Hill. He'll meet with the Republican leader, Speaker of the House Paul Ryan, the Republican leader Mitch McConnell. We'll be back with that.
Donald Trump today took in the view of his new hometown. House Speaker Paul Ryan showing Trump where he'll be sworn in as the 45th President of the United States.
Thanks, everybody. Thank you. Thanks, guys.
Trump and Ryan never photographed together during the campaign. Today, we're eager to present a united front.
We are now talking about how we're going to hit the ground running to make sure that we can get this country turned around and make America great again.
Thank you very much. Tight pool. Out this way, guys.
But where to start? On Capitol Hill today, a dizzying series of meetings.
Mr. President-elect, what's the first priority on day one?
A lot of priorities. A lot of really good priorities. People will be very, very happy.
At the top of Trump's to-do list,
we're going to look very strongly at immigration, we're going to look at border, we're going to look very strongly at health care, and we're looking at jobs, big league jobs.
The president-elect and Republicans agree the Obama health care law must go. But so far, no agreement on a plan to replace it. And since Election Day, we've seen that rush, 100,000 Americans scrambling to sign up for insurance.
Here it goes.
Before any work can be done, Trump needs a cabinet. His son-in-law, Jared Kushner, is being eyed for chief of staff. Today, he got a tour from the man who currently holds the job. Other cabinet contenders, Sarah Palin, Chris Christie, Newt Gingrich, and Rudy Giuliani, who even now is still taking shots at Hillary Clinton. Trump praised her on election night.
And we owe her a major debt of gratitude for her service to our country.
But today, Giuliani wouldn't rule out needing a special prosecutor to investigate Clinton.
So there are legal questions that are more complicated than just saying, let's forget about it.
Mary Bruce joins us tonight live from Capitol Hill. And Mary, Trump's running mate, Mike Pence, soon to be vice president, by his side for all of these meetings. And he'll play a key role brokering relationships between the White House and Congress.
Yeah, David, the vice president-elect will be a bridge connecting both sides of Pennsylvania Avenue. He knows Capitol Hill in and out, served here for 12 years, and is very close with House Speaker Paul Ryan. Pence also met today with Vice President Joe Biden, who's played a similar role for President Obama. David.
Mary Bruce on Capitol Hill tonight. Mary,